smoking on some OG. Well, I'm homegrown and I'm leaning on to my love.
What you do when you're not thinking? I'd be a damn fool if I let you slip. Yeah, if I let you slip out my grip, and I'm never trying to control you, but I can't take that risk. Not with this once in a lifetime, sports and a fried time. I save a lifeline, right place and right time. And I'm unworthy of your treasure, but I'm working under this pressure to keep you here forever. Cause you're rock solid, definition of loyal, elegant, empathetic, and enigmatically royal. You get on my damn nerves, bring my blood to a boil. But your heart is where my home is, your soul exists in my soil. I got deep feelings for you, I'm not afraid to show it. We've been nurturing this love we were searching for, so let's grow it. We were meant to be together forever, we both know it. If this is my chance at being your lover, I'm not gonna blow it. Cause I see what you do when you're not thinking. I'd be a damn fool if I let you slip. Yeah, if I let you slip out my grip, and I'm never trying to control you, but I can't take that risk. Not with this once in a lifetime, sports and a prime time. I save a lifeline, right place and right time. And I'm unworthy of your treasure, but I'm working under this pressure to keep you with forever. Cause I see what you do when you're not thinking. I'd be a damn fool if I let you slip, yeah. Slip out my grip, and I'm never trying to control you, but I can't take that risk, not with this,
no. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another vlog. We're going on a walk. We did F45 this morning.
Yes.
And Booker's right there. Hey, Book. Joy's putting her shoes on.
Do you see the ice near my boots?
Mm-hmm.
That's what was at the bottom.
And I'm under cold. My socks are wet now.
They are.
We went out and took Booker on a walk in the rain like 2 days ago. And our boots, our rain boots, filled up with water. And you had one right there, remember? And we left them on the front porch to dry out, and we put our boots on today, and there's still water in them. So Julia changed shoes. I'm just whatever. My socks are wet at this point.
Lucky baby.
Booker, come here.
Ooh, it's colder than it looks, huh?
It is. Well, because the sun shines out.
I know, but it's like.
But it's crisp. It's like 30 degrees.
Oh.
Good sit. Good boy. Good sit.
Okay. We're gonna try and do some stuff around the house today because we're having some friends over for dinner, so
yeah.
That always motivates us to get our house clean. We've slowed down on our house decor a little bit.
We have.
We kind of lost a little momentum there, but that's okay.
I think we got kind of discouraged when we gave up on doing everything the way we wanted, and we just had to like finish it for when family was coming into town. And now that it's done, we're like, how much do we want to change?
Right.
You know?
Right.
Which is a good problem to have. Like the house is in a good place, but it's just not like perfect to our standard.
Not much, nor will it ever be perfect,
yeah.
But
it'll always be better.
What's do you doing? Your paw's stuck on the frisbee. It's all the frisbee. You're not ready? Okay. Mm-hmm.
Oh my god, you guys, look at Booker's tail. It literally has dirt icicles on it. Hold on, it won't stop wagging.
Those are icicles.
Oh, those are icicles, buddy. How are we gonna thaw out your tail? Oh no, we're gonna have to figure that out. We'll do it, we'll find a why. All right, someone's in the shower. We didn't know what else to do with them, so we're like, we'll just get them in there and we're just gonna rinse off the dirt. Are you getting out of there?
Yeah, I'll put a bathing suit on.
Are you okay? It's melting. He's actually like fine in there. He's not whimpering or anything, which is interesting. Your snow is melting. I could see it dropping off your body. It's gonna be nice, Book. So warm. Is it warm? What do you think? Is that good? Wow. Oh my gosh, that's nice, huh? Sir. Is that wolves?
He likes it, I think.
Good job, Bucky.
Alright, we're doing bath time. I'm gonna order us some food. You want the normal from Radish? You want a split one? We order from there probably 3 times a week. It's really bad. We get the hot and crispy grain bowl with salmon. And it's our favorite thing ever. So good. So clean. We feel so good after we eat it. Tastes good. It's the best. Don't you think?
I can't hear what you're saying.
Talking to the camera.
Oh.
All right, that's ordered.
You ready, buddy? You're almost done. Last call.
Mm-hmm. Come here, baby. Oh. Wait, no. I know.
Silly.
Let me get a silly. Oh my god, you're such a dork.
What are you doing? You're crazy.
What?
Okay.
Perfect.
I'm gonna unpack my suitcases. I've been avoiding it.
Book, what do you think? Mom's gotta do it. Okay.
Okay, I'm annoying myself. Alright, I have 2 suitcases to unpack. One for Miami, and then we came back and we went straight to the mountains. So this is a literal disaster. I need someone to help me organize this closet. That's just gotten too out of control. But here we go.
You got me straight up hooked, feeling after your love, sense of humor and empathy, kindness, all the above. Girl, you the total package, you got every box checked, but it's the way you treat others that really got my respect. Don't get me wrong, girl, you're the bomb and I couldn't settle for less, but it's that muscle in your chest that truly got me possessed. I got your heart inside my hand and I'm holding a firm grip. Nobody like you even close, so I'm never gonna let you slip, cause I see what you do when you're not thinking. I'd be a damn fool if I let you slip, yeah. Slip out my grip and I'm never trying to control you, but I can't take that risk, not with this, no. No, I can't take that risk, not when I see what you do when you're not thinking. I'd be a damn fool if I let you slip.
All right, taking a break for lunch. Radish is so good. If you're ever visiting Nashville or you're local to Nashville, Radish is where it's at. I put a hair treatment in my hair. I don't usually wear this unless I put a hair treatment in.
What did you put in?
It's like K19 or K18. Mm-hmm. What's it called?
The one that you gave me?
Mm-hmm.
I haven't seen it. But...
since I have curly hair, my hair dries out really fast.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a nice, like,
Hydrating,
like, oil base. Otherwise it just, like, turns into a frizz ball.
Yeah.
I'm not super curly, but definitely have curls. We can do a few more things around the house before I have to go to my acupuncture appointment. And then I thought I can come back and pick you up and go to the Whole Foods.
I look for a meal.
You want my protection.
Julia got her desk that came in right here, and we're gonna move it right here and get this one out of here to open up this space.
Tell me what you think about. Do you think about me? Living all alone in your apartment. Do you ever get lonely? Oh. And I've been feeling weak in my knees, but I just wanna lean in. You
only reason, you're the only season. And I just wanna please you, cause all I ever think about is you. You warm my blood, tear through my lungs. Won't you say something like I'm the one under your thumb? It's
Bucky, we're in the middle of something. I mean, two even looks cute. Two almost looks, do you think it looks better? Whatever, we'll just put it up because we got them. Found these posters in Paris, actually. Hunter and I were at a street vendor. You can go back and watch the Paris vlog. And there's actual footage of us looking for the posters, and it was really fun. They're like vintage Parisian advertisements. And yeah, I love them. This is making me happy to see these go up. Making me feel inspired.
We've had them for a while.
I know. We got them framed and everything, and
yeah, they were just little posters. We had them framed by our framer that did some framework for us.
Yeah. What? You got to go to the bedrooms? Take Booker out. Go ahead. Yay! Oh, it looks so good! Wow, it looks so like done. I love it. Gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous. Yay! I have a nook. I envisioned that nook for so long. I'm like, ugh, I just did not like that desk in here, but I have a whole different idea for in here, but this actually is not as much space in here.
All right, I am running to the acupuncturist real quick. It takes about an hour, and it's cupping for the first 15 minutes, and then the acupuncture for 30, and then about a 10 or 15 minute like massage where they kind of like work on areas of your body that have been problematic. So my lower back has always been kind of a thing the past couple years. Some of y'all know about it if you follow along. So I just kind of have them focus on my lower back and my glutes depending on how they're feeling, because usually it's my lower back slash glute where my sciatic nerve is, so they all kind of connect to each other, and that's where they work. So it's a doctor's office, so super professional. And it's really helped me even more than like a chiropractor. I haven't been to the chiropractor in a while, but I used to do both every week. And then when we went out of town a couple times, I just hadn't picked up the chiropractor again since then. So I'm gonna probably add that to the regimen again here pretty soon. But for now, the acupuncturist is what I like because it's all natural and holistic. So anywho, I'm gonna get to it.
Good morning. Hi, Bookie. Good morning, you guys. It is Sunday, and Hunter went to the gym. I was not feeling inspired to work out today. Come on, babe. Let's go back inside. Come on. So I slept in, and I might get on that Peloton tread later or something, or go for a walk, but I just wasn't feeling like that gym grind this morning. It wasn't it for me. But yeah, I've been laying in bed. I just ordered Starbucks delivery, and I was watching actually some like old throwback YouTube videos. Just actually not even old throwback videos, just like older channels that I used to watch. Like I used to watch Aspen and Parker, and I was watching some hauls. Actually, I don't even know who the girl's name is, but people that have been on YouTube for a really long time, and it just got me like kind of in my feels about YouTube and just like how much I love YouTube and like why I even started doing it in the first place years ago. And yeah, I was just like, you know what, I feel like it's just time for a little chat and update with you guys, and I just wanted to explain kind of where I've been at and what we've been kind of going through the past few months and everything. I know that we've obviously kept you guys in the loop a lot with like so many conversations. I feel like if you go into the vlogs from the past few months, it's been just like so many talks about anxiety and social media and all this stuff. And I just wanted to like kind of give like a full rounded update about it. Bookie, I need you to entertain yourself while I'm updating them on our life, okay? Booker. Okay. Booker. What? I can't believe you just did that. Okay. Oh, you're coming out. Okay. Cool. Okay, well, you gotta be quiet if you're gonna be up here, okay? Come here. Sit down. Sit and lay down. Okay, hold on. Let me get this kid a bully stick. Oh, my Atlanta. One second. Come here. Okay, down. Go. Be right back. Come on. Okay, sit on your bed. Okay, I'm back. All right, I feel like basically, like as of, let's see, probably like 6 months ago, I started to feel just really, really anxious about social media as our job in general. And I don't know what it was or like what really like triggered it or what I like kind of had the realization about, but I think just in general, like sharing so much for so long, I think during COVID, actually, I met one of you guys in person the other day, and I was like telling one of you about this whole journey, and I was like, you know what? And the subscriber was like, totally, like I totally understand, and like I think it made a lot of sense to them. So I was like, maybe it's worth filling you guys in on like the full picture, just so that you kind of are able to put all the puzzle pieces together, because it could be a little bit confusing, or you might just be thinking that I'm having a mental breakdown, which. I didn't have a mental breakdown, but I just was like actually just going through a lot of emotions. And I feel like if people have emotions these days, it's like, oh my God, what's wrong with them? Which is actually kind of hypocritical, because the whole irony of our culture right now is like, let people have their mental health. Like it's not, shouldn't be taboo. But then the minute that you share that you're maybe going through something, everyone's like, oh my God, like they're so unhappy and what's wrong with your life? You need to be grateful, all this stuff. Anyways, you get it. This is just for you normal people that actually understand. So if you have something like not nice to say, I'm not even reading it, because I'm not doing that anymore. Anyway, so basically what happened after COVID, I think COVID was just a really weird time for everybody. And I think kind of one of the ways that Hunter and I were able to like cope with it was by like vlogging a lot. So it was like there was nothing else to do, and we love vlogging. We love sharing and everything. And it was so much fun. We were like, cool, like let's record every day. Everyone else is like wants to hang out, you know. There was nothing to do, so we were just vlogging so much for 2 years, and kind of just got in this like really big like habit of sharing everything, sharing every day. And I think at one point, like when we moved to Nashville, I really wanted to kind of develop on working. I wanted to work on developing our life outside of work, even though our work is our life, so it's very blurred. This is just a really odd job, I guess you could say. It's complicated, because it's like you are sharing your life even though it's also your work at the same time, so it blurs the line, which is like traditionally in any other profession people are like, do not blur the line between work and personal life, because it's so complicated. And that's like exactly the definition of this job, is blurring the lines between the two. So that just like in general makes it really mentally difficult to draw boundaries and balance for yourself in this position. So anyways, after moving to Nashville, we started like, you know, having creating a lot of friendships that actually like weren't people that were like on social media, which allowed us like a lot more time offline, and you know, just having like little bit more of like a grounded experience. And I think the more and more of that that we created, and we were coming out of COVID, and I think it was kind of happening for everyone, I just realized this, like, I realized the, I don't know, kind of, I was feeling super anxious, and kind of like this wake up call of like, oh my gosh, like all I really do is work, and I don't have enough balance in my life at all, and it's making me super anxious. And then layered on top of that, I had realized that it, as a result of sharing so much on the internet, that you know, you're just like a million times as vulnerable as anyone else, because you open yourself up to so many opinions, which is like an obvious, right? But until you actually go through it, I don't think you really understand the impact that it has on like your brain and your like your emotions, because it's not really normal for one person to open up their messages or their YouTube comments and see. You could just go on any video and read like 300 different opinions about what someone thought about your video, or they have a comment about your marriage, or about the way that you, you know, decorate your house, or your outfit, or your body, or your dog, or anything, right? It's like really complicated. So that definitely starts to take a toll, because when you have so many of those like opinions flying into your head, you know they're not real, but at a certain sense you're like, it does, it's like their voices, right? So you kind of like, if it triggers any sort of insecurity, you're kind of like, ooh, like, well, are they right? Like, am I like, you know, is that true? Are they seeing something that I'm not seeing? Like, it's really like psychologically, it's pretty fucked. So anyways, you can imagine just kind of like having that wake up call, I guess, at some point. You're like, whoa, this is not healthy. And I think that's kind of like where we were at. Hunter's a little bit like, he's a little bit more mentally tough than me, a lot more mentally tough than me. But I just like really put my heart out on the line, and I'm like, I probably share everything like too soon. That's just like the kind of person that I am. I don't really like guard myself very much, which I'm learning to do more and like draw more boundaries for myself. But I realized that I needed more boundaries in my life, and especially with YouTube and work. And so with that, I started kind of like, you guys know I love like thinking about culture and philosophy and stuff like that. Like, I started to think in, as I was going through my own journey with how I was perceiving myself on through social media and thinking about social media expectations, I just had so many thoughts about like how it's shaped our culture, and how it affects behavior, how it's affected my behavior, and how it can really have such a big impact on how we behave and how we express ourselves and everything, because it's such a big part of it. So that was like really why I thought it was important just to like have all those candid conversations on the videos, just because I know if I'm feeling that way, there's got to be other people like that are thinking about that. So I obviously love social media. I think it's like used for so much good, and it's a way to bring people together and connect people, which is exactly what we all need. But if it gets out of line, or if you don't have your healthy boundaries set, it can be harmful, like, on your mental health. You know what I mean? So I think what I've gone through the past 6 months is just my own journey, figuring out what that balance looks like and how I can kind of come back to social media with a fresh perspective and just, like, a renewed kind of set of standards for myself, and just like how much I'm willing to share, how much privacy do I need, even though I love this and like I really want to do it. Like, I, and that's kind of what got me thinking about it this morning, watching old YouTube videos. I was like, oh, I remember just like little Juge and Hunt that wanted to just like have a YouTube channel and vlog, and it was just like so pure and innocent until it got smashed by all the freaking haters and all of the opinions and stuff. So that's kind of where I'm at. But anyways, it's all really good things. I think just people aren't used to hearing so many like deep emotions, and I just think about myself at a very like deep level, and I that's how I express myself. So if you've been wondering like what the All right. Sorry, I got cut off. Anyways, so I feel like it's just like growing and going through changes. And I'm actually like literally so happy that I have gone through this awakening, I guess you could say, because I'm so much happier now and have been able to create so much more meaning and like purpose in my life by setting boundaries and realizing like what areas of my life were, you know, draining or taking away from like my joy, or maybe weren't like, wasn't putting like my values in the right places. And yeah, just reevaluating that and getting it back into a place where I feel really good about and know where I'm moving forward. And Hunter and I, or we obviously have our own like spiritual journeys, but they obviously have so much overlap because we are married. So I'm just vouching for myself. Hunter and I are really different, even though we're married and we're similar. He obviously like has been like my little therapist through all this. And he's just like a super grounded person, and I am so thankful for him and just being like my confidant and everything. But he has been like the rock of our family, and yeah, but I feel so good and so happy moving forward because now I'm so glad I like figured out where areas were wrong and was able to make improvements and changes. And I feel, oh my gosh, cut off again. Okay, sorry, I think Booker has to go to the bathroom. You need to go to the bathroom? Go potty. Don't run away. Booker, go to the bathroom. Go potty. As I was saying, oh my god, I can't. I like, this is my last attempt at this clip and then I'm over it. I'm like, the universe does not want me to do this clip or something. It's your stick. Where's your stick? Huh? Your lip is caught. Excuse me, sir. Booker. Book, where's your stick? Could you go get it for us? That'd be perfect. Thanks. Okay, come here. Sit. Yeah, to wrap it up, I feel so much happier in such a better place, and I'm just like, growing and changing, and it feels so good. Like, gosh, if you are not growing and changing and realizing things and taking responsibility for your own happiness and understanding like where you are making mistakes in your unhappiness and not blaming everyone else, like blaming it on everyone else, you're gonna be so much better off, and you are in control of your own happiness and stress and joy, and you can do whatever you want to like alter that, change it, make it better. You can put those boundaries in places, figure out what actually makes you happy, and make changes in your life to implement those. And that's just what I've been going through the past 6 months, and it makes me really happy and nice to see when so many of you are so sweet and like you're like, I can just like see that you're so different or like less anxious, you just seem calmer, and that makes me really happy because that's, if other people can feel the energy shift, then that means that I'm making progress. And I mean, I know I am, but it's nice to hear it from other people. Excuse me, I need you to relax. So yeah, that's all good things, but I just kind of wanted to give you guys like a full life update so you really like understand where I'm at. And I will not stop sharing on YouTube, but we will not stop sharing on YouTube or Instagram. And we always like plan on sharing everything. Like, gosh, I don't even know when we would stop, but I think we just needed to go through a period of figuring out where we can like kind of create some lines and structure, and what things we need to keep like private for us and how much we're able to, vlog and share with you guys in order to like keep our sanity and like keep ourselves happy and like mentally stable and all that stuff. So it's definitely like a hard world with social media, and you have to be super hyper aware of creating balance and stuff. So that's just, it's just been the first phase that we've kind of been working through that and realizing it and everything. And yeah, I'm excited to, you know, just be on here. I'm so grateful for this position. But yeah, I am so grateful for you guys, so grateful that you've stuck through the journey, and hopefully like hearing all of the like crazy conversations and details will help you maybe evaluate some things in your own life that you can make changes in, or affirms that you feel like you have a good balance. So that's good either way, but I just think that us sharing will hopefully help somebody and for the better. So yeah, we love you guys. We could not do this without you, obviously, and we're not going anywhere anytime soon. I know people are like, oh no, are you like not gonna be on YouTube anymore? Are you guys gonna stop vlogging? No, we will never do that. We just needed a little bit of like time to figure out what our YouTube journey from here on is going to look like, and it might just be not quite as frequent. I mean, I don't think what we were doing, sharing like 5-6 vlogs a week, is sustainable for the rest of your life, or you literally won't have a life. So I think during COVID that made sense because there wasn't really anything else going on, but for a real life now, there's just gonna be a little bit, need to be a little bit more balanced. So we'll still be here always though, and sharing and everything, but it just might look a little bit different than what you guys are used to. So still here, and can't wait to take you guys along our journey of all of our next years and everything. When we have babies, all that stuff, we're not going anywhere, so don't worry. So that's my update. Wanted to fill you guys in. If you thought I was crazy, well, I am a little crazy. Welcome to the club. But I actually don't care. Like, sorry, I think everyone's crazy. So if you like, we're all a little cuckoo. That's the beauty of this world, right? Like, we're all like nutso trying to figure it out, and that's life. So love you guys. Good talk. I'm gonna go drink some coffee and watch more YouTube vlogs, just like I used to do back in the old days. And yeah,
so also, here's the current status of my office after yesterday. The light's so pretty right now, you can't really tell. Well, you can. But I've been wanting to do this forever, get that desk out of here, and it actually looks really good in Hunter's office, even though that was supposed to be like a standing desk area or like whatever, but I think this looks good in here. Really makes a lot of sense, and worked out well because it's dark wood and this is like dark walls. So I don't know, I still kind of like, I don't feel like this room is done. Didn't really like, I even have a vision right now. It just is what it is. So yeah, it's like not necessarily complete, but I just thought I'd show you guys what's in here right now because this is just what it is. I don't know. Decorating is kind of a evolving thing, and I think I haven't really known really what I want the function of this room to be completely, so that's why it's been so like interchangeable. So anyways, I did really want to just get a smaller desk and put it in this little corner nook because the big desk was just not working. I would have originally wanted the desk in the window, but it just didn't really work out there. Actually, that would look really good, but this is cute, and I don't really spend that much time at my desk. I'm more like shooting or doing like creative things, so I don't really even need that much computer time, so I didn't want that big of an area of the room dedicated to that because that just wouldn't really make sense. So I really like it over there. It's small, it's cozy. I already like want to go sit at that desk more. It's like more inspiring. And have my little posters from Paris, which are so cute, and I'm so glad we finally got them hung up. They look so good. And yeah, I just love this little nook. I don't know what it is, but I'm obsessed with it. These chairs, I don't know if they'll stay in here. I'm thinking like I might turn this area more into a kind of like a creative room, like craft room type of thing. Like, I'm not really sure yet. Maybe like a big desk, not desk, sorry, big table in the middle where I like store a lot of stuff. I don't really know. So still brainstorming, or it can just be like a sitting room, I don't know, to shoot. But these were the chairs that were in here on the other side of my desk. So just kind of flip them back this way. And these ottomans we got at the vintage store the other day, and actually really like the contrast of the mix of the ottoman with the chairs. It looks really cute. I need to restyle this wooden piece. I just haven't really gotten around to it, but just a bunch of books and junk basically. And then I've got my mirror over there, which kind of over this mirror actually. I like it, but I don't think it fits with the vibe of like what I'm doing. So something more modern probably, I think, would be better, but she's cute, whatever. Also was thinking about hanging this heart above there, but I don't know, I kind of like it simple. Yeah, and so right now, really what I do in here is, like, I'll come read, I'll do, like, emails on my iPad in here, I will, it's, like, kind of, like, just a creative room, like, good vibes. If I have to, like, open packages, like, I do that in here, maybe come up with outfits, stuff like that. I will, take outfit content in this mirror. That's why I have these chairs kind of shifted, because I need to be able to get in here. And, yeah, so kind of TBD on what this room's really gonna be, but this is kind of, like, the nook that I feel like will stay. This is this part that will stay, and then obviously the beautiful wooden piece, but I think I want to do, like, I think I want to make, like, a big piece of artwork to go on that thing, and then probably more of, like, a long table situation with storage for, like, crafts, and I want this to be, like, a creative, like, art room, basically, like, not really a traditional office or studio, but, anyway, so I'm only the only one that can probably figure that out. But if you guys are curious what all the changes in this room have been, that's why. And if I don't end up using these chairs in here, they will look adorable somewhere else in the house, so I'm not worried. Yeah, but that's kind of the deal. So it's cute. I'm happy that I already, like, so much happier when I look in here. I just love that little area. I was staring at it last night. We had some friends over for dinner, and just, like, seeing this out of the corner of my eye made me so happy. Just, like, that little situation. I don't know what it is, but I'm just obsessed, so I love it.
We, for dinner, we are combining some home chefs.
Yeah.
With some leftover kale salad we had a couple nights ago.
So I made the salad, and I feel like it might be kind of good with the chicken, but.
Should we kind of combine the two salads, or yeah, have them
or
separate?
Or we can have them separate and have a salad party. How many more minutes do we have left? Fine.
Because I feel like the kale salad's already dressed.
Yeah.
And so if we don't eat it tonight, it might not be good.
Well, it stays pretty good because it's kale.
Yeah.
Sorry, book. This is not a sponsor for Home Chef, but we are obsessed with them. I think it's probably my favorite out of all the meal thingies.
But it's just
like
different.
Simple recipes.
It's simple.
I like simple.
Look, it's the easiest. It might not be the healthiest, but it's, like, the easiest.
Right, right. I know. It's probably not. I think actually Green Chef, the one we do, is the healthiest, and that's why we like it.
Yeah.
But sometimes you just don't want to be healthy.
But I would also say I feel like these, not because they're not healthy, but I would say these probably taste better.
Yeah, they're not.
We had one for lunch too, and it was shrimp pasta.
Oh,
it was
so good. I feel like it just hits. Mm-hmm. I don't know. I didn't do salt and pepper. I thought we just do it on top. So I didn't want to make another dish, so I was trying to be smart.
It is smart.
Courteous to the man that does the dishes.
In there?
Yeah, I pinch it then.
No, go ahead, get your pinch.
Yeah. What if we started going back to evening workouts? I don't know though. I kind of feel like it messes up my whole day not having workout in the morning. It scares me.
I go to evening workouts at F45 if we can knock out something else in the morning.
I know.
Maybe like a
walk with Booker.
A walk or a hike. Or
I know.
Yoga.
But the thing is, the workout kind of gets our asses out of bed.
I know. And it's, like, consistent.
I know.
Reliable.
It is reliable.
Yeah, I love F45. Like,
I know.
I love.
It was like a lifesaver.
It was a lifesaver, a life changer.
Yeah.
It really helped us with
it. Really worked for us.
Our health journey.
It really
gave us, like,
yeah,
structure to our days. Like, when we started when we both went full time in our business, it gave us structure to our days when we didn't have structure.
And when we were, like, we had, like, COVID and we were, you know, kind of isolated, the gym was, like, all we had.
Not when we had COVID, but when COVID was locked down in its prime.
Yeah, and, like, our gym was still open, and, like, you would get your temperature and all that. It, like, saved us. Like,
yeah.
Just some interaction, some, like, an outlet. Like, mentally, it was really healthy.
And, like, all the workouts. We've talked about this before. Like, we've done every type of workout.
Yeah.
I've done college football workouts, CrossFit, all kinds of different yoga classes. You've done bar classes.
Yeah.
Just like everything, to me, it was the most sustainable.
Totally. And pushes you.
It pushes you every time, but it's not impossible every time.
I know.
You don't leave feeling sick. And I remember, like, there used to be workouts where I'd just, like, leave being like, why do I do this? This is making me sick, or it'd be ones that I don't get, like, something
it's
out of.
It's just enough hard, but still, like, fun.
Right.
But it doesn't work for everyone. I had, somebody told me they went to F45 and they didn't like it.
I think you got to give it a chance, too.
Yeah. I think I,
like, some people don't give things a chance.
It's just like any other HIIT workout. HIIT training's kind of addicting.
I'm saying that, and maybe, like, people wouldn't like it. I don't know. Maybe I'm biased, but... Or I definitely am biased. But I think people should give it a chance. Like, you can't just go one time and maybe it was like a hard day and you're like, oh, I didn't like it that day.
Well, you have to find the workout also that works for you.
I know.
And that might not be F45 for everybody. Stir.
But anyways, we're just saying, like, if y'all are at all considering F45, it is... definitely worth attempting and worth trying out, and go to the week-long trial. Like,
yeah,
try it out.
Week-long trial at most gyms. You get a free week.
Like, it makes us so happy when we get messages from y'all where you're like, hey, like, I've been going to F45 because of you guys and it's changed my life. And that happens,
we're
believe
like,
it or not, like, happens every week. We
I
get
know,
like
we
a
get
new
so
message
many messages,
every week,
which is cool,
all around the world of people saying,
because it changed our lives.
Yeah.
So we're like, we
thanks for
we
getting,
love it
thanks for sharing your F45 journey, because it pushed me to go for the first time and I'm obsessed or whatever.
Totally.
It makes us happy to see that, and I think all of you would like it if you gave it a try, or if you're looking for something new. That's all,
really?
That's all I have
and
to say.
And we did not
that.
Get paid a smidge to go there.
No.
Like,
we buy our memberships.
We pay for it. We chose it.
We're not a, it's not a partnership. No. I mean, it technically is. Like, they're helping us with our health and lifestyle.
And we're telling everyone about them
because
we love them. So I guess that is. Okay, you want to go ahead and pour the cream over the chicken?
Mm-hmm.
You don't grab that with your hand. Grab it with your
hand. I ain't grabbing it at all.
Book, what's going on with you, Book? Hmm? You having a good day?
Yes. Oh, looks so good. Wow. Yums, Book. Yummers.
Share a beer?
Yeah.
That's good. At the moment, we have been at a place, we kind of talked a little bit about discovering new, like, not even discovering new things, but just trying new things for fun.
Mm-hmm.
Just to explore and venture out of, like, the norm.
Mm-hmm.
We've been challenging ourselves to do it and trying to, like, find new activities. Not to bring us, like, joy that we're lacking, but to find
add to the repertoire.
Yeah, like, to find new things, and like, it's fun trying new things. Like, even if it's one time, like, it could be a blast, but it doesn't mean you're gonna keep going back. Like, go rock climbing,
mm-hmm.
go jump on trampolines, and
mm-hmm.
do whatever. So we've been doing that, or like finding new things to explore, or like painting classes. We want to take a French class,
mm-hmm.
and learn French.
We want to sew.
Yep.
We want to learn how
we
to
do
pottery. We need more talent.
We want to sew. I want to get into
more skills.
I want to get into like upholstery,
mm-hmm.
which I guess is sewing.
Mm-hmm.
But like, there's certain time, like certain things we find at vintage stores that you can take it to someone to like reupholster it for you.
Mm-hmm.
But like, I want to play with fabrics.
Mm-hmm.
I want to try different things.
I know.
I want you to find a fabric you like, and then us try to make like a robe out of it.
Mm-hmm.
Or find us a footstool that we like and try to play with different fabrics on it. Like, I want to test and have the skills to do so.
Mm-hmm.
And it just takes practice, I think.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's the reason why you try things. Because you also might try it and not like it.
Yeah, but then you cross off the list and you can move forward.
Right.
You know,
and then
that's
you know,
not
like,
the vibe I tried it.
But you could still want to, like, redo different items, but then you know you don't want to do it yourself. It's too much of a hassle. You might take it to someone at that point.
Mm-hmm.
But
What's worth it to you?
It's like woodworking. I'm not necessarily like a carpenter or like the best woodworker, but I enjoy it and I learn something new every time I've done a project.
Yeah.
That I wouldn't learn if I didn't do the project. Like, you pick up new tools, you learn new skill sets. I know this sounds basic to you guys, but it's not basic to everyone.
You and you discover things about yourself, like, as you try and
yeah.
Because you're like, you're entering it, you're going, venturing into a new area of your heart and your brain that you've never entered. And like you've never challenge. Done it before.
And for us, because we do so much together, it's fun to do things separate and find like independent passions, but it's also fun to try new things together. Mm-hmm. And you kind of vibe off each other. Yeah. It's good that we like are into the same thing. Like, we have a lot of the similar passions, which mm-hmm. we're thankful for.
Well,
but it also makes it harder for us to then go pursue like our own passions, which we also do enjoy.
It's like a lot of the same things. If you and I have all that in common, then like I would say that's a win.
No, we definitely see it as something.
Whereas people that are like,
we're fortunate. Me and
we're independent. And it's like, why? We're married.
I know. I don't get
that's
that.
That's the point.
I understand it, but it's like weird to tell another couple that. Mm-hmm. It's like kind of bizarre. Because our marriage is great, and we met having similar passions, and we've grown in those passions together,
mm-hmm.
which is a great thing. You do you. But I say all this because...
Book.
It's important to challenge your partner to try new things. It's important for you to try new things, whether it's together or independent. I'm not forcing you to go like whittle wood sticks with me, right?
Encouraging me in the things that I like.
Yeah.
Like being like, yeah, you should do that.
But if we want to build a piece of furniture together, it'd be fun if like I could do the woodworking side of things and
totally.
You could do some mock-ups. We can mock up together, do the fabrics, and then we both know how to like upholster it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like that's kind of the route I think we want to get into at some point.
Mm-hmm.
Not for business purposes, but for like ourselves. Like, we just want to be able to do that and see our creations around the house.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not talking like little DIYs. I'm talking like
me sure
thought out projects.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think I'm not a big DIY person. I mean, I am.
I'm not either.
I'm a DIY person in the terms of like do things myself.
Mm-hmm.
But the term DIY to me sounds like knockoff, and I don't like that.
I know.
Shit.
I know. It has like a bad connotation, like cheap or something.
Yeah, if you want to do it yourself, create something of your own.
Mm-hmm.
So be creative and create your own shit.
All right, Hunter's finishing up the dishes. I'm gonna make a fire, and I think we're gonna.
One of our wine glasses broke again.
It did? Shoot, we gotta order more. We've been, well, we started reading a book together and doing a little story time. It was really fun. We did it last night by the fire, so we're gonna do it again. Huh, Bookie? You wanna join? It's like a little family time, Book.
You gonna start the fire? I'm gonna take the trash out.
Okay.
There's the beer.
Our friends Tian and Sam came over last night and they brought ice cream from Jenny's, which is so good, and we never buy ice cream because it's just not good, and try to stay away from sugar and desserts as much as we can unless it's literally like out for dinner or something. But they left the ice cream here, so we're like, sometimes it's fun to just indulge and be like, let's read a book by the fire with some ice cream. It's just fun. Sometimes you just gotta live a little and just eat the ice cream, eat the garbage. It's fun memories, huh?
It is, even though it's so bad for us and sugar's not good for us. It makes our brains crazy. Okay, we've got to remember that. But every once in a while, it's a fun treat. It's all about the balance, right, Book? Okay. You gotta remember, feed your body good things most of the time, but then sometimes you gotta have fun with it. And you gotta treat yourself just a little bit. You have the fun things, okay? You get bully sticks every day, so you know nothing about that. You get treats every single day. Every day is fun for you. Wow!
I know.
Don't you?
bud.
It's your dad.
It's just your dad. We're having a little pup talk on ice cream. Should we go for a shortcut?
Anyways.
Yeah.
Cheers. Emmy? This is a good night routine. We've got our fire blowing.
All right, so we're gonna do a little bit of reading time together. We started doing this last night where we just like take turns reading chapters and pick a book that might inspire you and vibe off of it. So
yeah.
We're gonna read a little bit tonight.
I'm ready.
You want me to read it?
No, you got to read last night.
I know. I'm offering
to. You
didn't
even let me read a chapter.
I gave it to you and then we got up and started vibing. Oh yeah, this chapter only 2 pages. You got it. Can we read the 2-page chapter?
No. I'm afraid I have some very bad news.
Yeah, I lost my way. Damn, I lost my mind. Pedal to the metal, let the devil lead me blind. I was way outside the lines. Yeah, and I got away off track. Took some wrong turns, looking back, it's been one hell of a ride in my review. I thank the good Lord for the detours to you.
A reading time. Honestly? It's been like the most transformative thing of my week is our reading sessions. It might be that book too, but it's like the connection, the conversations around it. It's mm-hmm. like really gets me like juicy. I'm like.
It helped me think about.
Like my brain. I'm like.
It helped me think about where our eyes are set on. Yeah. Which is all the extra noise.
Exactly. It brings you back to focus, which is like also what. The book was talking about all the noise, the outside world. Like, put that phone away once in a while and just recenter your mind.
I like that we have our own books that we're reading right now.
Mm-hmm.
But I like that we have that book that we can like share.
I got it.
And it was like the perfect book for us to share.
What kind of makes it more doable to do it together?
Yeah, you just like switch off chapters.
Yeah.
A little popcorn reading.
Mm-hmm.
We've talked about popcorn readings before on this channel.
Mm-hmm.
And the memories of them and how they used to like stress us out in school.
And the fact that you're like when you're reading with someone, it's like you're getting like a human bonding experience.
And you're sharing those thoughts.
There's
together.
Like an extra spark than if you were reading them by yourself.
Totally.
Yeah.
And also hearing it out loud. Like when do you ever read out loud?
Never.
Like I like
it's like so ancient.
Like I liked when you would read. But yeah. I also really liked when I was reading because when you read out loud, you
like practice.
You hear more.
I know. And you focus.
You soak it in. The weird part is when you're reading, I'm not focused on my thoughts. I'm focused on what you're saying.
I know.
But afterward, all my thoughts are like true, genuine.
They're like
thoughts
better.
And pure.
I know.
It's really weird.
They're not like you're almost
as if it's like while you're reading, these thoughts are coming to your mind, but you're not thinking about them yet.
I know, because you're focused on something else. It's like a time...
But what I'm trying to say is, like, it's weird that those thoughts come after the reading's over as if they're something you've been thinking about, but they're brand new thoughts.
I know!
And they're so clear.
I know!
It's kind of cool. And we're not high, you guys. We're not,
high, you guys. We're stone cold sober.
We're stoked. We're high on life.
God. I mean... Getting high can be fun and spark some thoughts, but like, how can you do it without it is the magic. It's like
definitely recommend reading together.
Totally.
Aloud. If you're in a relationship or you have a partner, you're married, dating.
Try it.
Read out loud. It's fun.
Fun.
Find a book that you're both interested in.
So super fun.
I think the interest is important. Like you both have to be interested in it. It can't be just one of you. Y'all choose a book together and take turns reading chapters aloud.
Totally.
It's so super full.
So liberal. I have oil in my eyes. Alright. I am doing some hyaluronic acid. This is the youth serum from Skin Farm. It is a skincare place here in Nashville. Basically just like a hyaluronic acid serum. You can buy their products online though. So if you're interested, I think it's pretty similar to like any other hyaluronic acid, but peptides in it and some other stuff. I don't know. So good though. And then
I'm gonna use my Ultra Repair Cream from First Aid Beauty. My ride or die. If you have sensitive skin, you just need like a nice moisturizer. This moisturizer changed the game for me. It's so good. Great under makeup. It's wonderful. This is SkinCeuticals. I don't actually know if it's been that game changing, but it is expensive, so I'm using it, but I don't know. I didn't really notice like that big results from it. I love the way it smells and I love the texture, but I don't know if it's actually doing anything. So.
What is it?
It's like night cream.
What brand?
SkinCeuticals.
Well, if it smells good and it's a smell you like,
I know.
Then it might be worth it because that's something that like is appealing when it comes to
good like experience.
Facial hair is such a hassle.
Quick book, you wanna come in here? Come on, buddy. Wanna come to your bed? Come to your bed, let's go. Let's go. Come on. Come on. Let's go to your bed. Let's go to your bed.
There's a pajama party in Mom and Dad's room.
Go to your bed. Go to your bed. Go to your bed. Good boy.
Oh, no.
Good boy. Want us to turn your lamp off? Your night light?
Okay.
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 Alright, you guys.
Okay.
That's it for this evening. It's like 10:15.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm exhausted.
Me too.
Tired in a good way.
I know. Like, ready to fall asleep and hit the hay.
I know.
Such a good feeling.
So good.
There's nothing worse than knowing you didn't, like, fulfill your... anything of the day, and you're like wide awake at night. It's just like this helplessness.
Well, it's like we had a good lunch and dinner, a good workout. We got a lot of work done today.
We
did stuff around the house.
I know.
We didn't walk Booker today.
We didn't.
It was like the
Booker.
First time we haven't walked him in a while.
We always walk him every day, and we do like an hour of frisbee, and like we just like skip today.
I think it's good change up for him though. Honestly, like we've been giving him a lot of workouts, and it's almost like he comes back like more energized lately. And tonight he is a little bit more mellow.
I know. Well, and he thinks he's like the priority and like he's not. Or he can't think he is. He is the priority, but he can't think he's the priority.
He needs to be integrated into our life instead of our life.
I know. We're like a Booker.
But I love our walks.
Me too.
Like we need a moment today to take him on a walk.
And it was just nice though to have like some time to like focus on other things and not stress about that.
I know.
Like
I didn't think about the walk though until just now.
I thought about it a few times, but I was like,
my mind's been elsewhere.
Filming Princess Polly Hall, which should be up by now, probably.
My mind is at a place right now that is like, I have so much going on in my mind and feel like so many to-dos, like unorganized to-dos that are just like up in my head.
Mm-hmm.
And that because there's so many of them, it's like overflowing. That it just feels like a trash can that's overflowing that you, like, don't want to pick up. Like,
you're like, I don't even, like, the laundry room when it's over, you're like, I don't want to go in there.
Yeah. Like, I'm, like, avoiding going into my head and, like, tackling all the to-dos I have. I'm still doing a lot of stuff around the house and, like, a lot of things with work that I need to do. But there's some, like, pressing work things that I need to do that are just, like...
Well, we don't want to stress them out with that, but...
No. I'm saying, I just mean, like, that's where my head is at. Yeah. Just, like, I feel like everyone goes through that with their works, too, and your jobs. And I'm at a place where I'm realizing, like, that's okay. It's, like, tackle one thing at a time. Like, I've always done, like, go back to my old ways of just tackling tasks. And they'll all be completed over time.
Exactly.
But I'm feeling good about it. Lately, I've been, like, kind of stressing about it and just
feeling like... You just, like, the way out of that is, like, yeah, it's, like, just action. It's, like, just maybe doing one thing. And then you're, like, okay, now, I did a task. Okay, now I can do another one. Like... It seems so daunting when it's, like, a mountain high, though.
Yeah.
Like, you're like, I don't even want to go near it. I thought we could maybe end the vlog with, like, some gratitude, a positive.
Mm-hmm.
that were, you know, maybe something you're grateful for or a good moment from the day. Well, obviously the highlight of my day was the reading session.
Mm-hmm.
I love that. I like it because we get to spend time together that's like just pure like fun. It's like not tied to a performance of any kind or nobody else is included. It's just between me and you.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like relaxing, it's calming, it's fulfilling, and we get to do it together, and like it's just, I like it.
I like it a lot. I would say something similar to that, but like the moment right when the reading stops.
Yeah.
And like our creativity comes out.
Totally.
And we have these like hour long conversations with each other.
I know.
That's
so fun.
Really shed light to like what our future is going to be.
Mm-hmm.
And today the highlight was that moment after the reading when it started again and our creative wheel started to turn.
Yeah.
Because it happened to us yesterday.
Yeah.
And during that moment, I was like, I hope this is like consecutive and like,
I know,
continuous. I hope we continue to have conversations like this after we have these reading moments.
And it's like a little like ritual we keep our whole life.
No, totally.
And maybe like when we have babies and kids, like we do like nighttime reading, and it's like so fun.
Yeah. Oh, I agree.
That other thing with that is like having those ideas. One thing that I thought was really cool in the book we read was they were saying that ideas, like things that you see in your head, like an idea basically, mm-hmm, doesn't mean that it's just a wish. It means that like it happens like first in your mind and then it happens outside of your mind, like in reality. So like for instance, Hunter and Julia, we wanted to start a YouTube channel years ago, and then like here we are, here's the YouTube channel. So it happens in here first and then you can make it come true.
Mm-hmm.
That's like where it begins. Like it doesn't come out of nothing.
Everything
like,
starts with a thought.
So it's cool.
And then an action.
Which just shows you can literally just, if you have ideas in your head, they're there for a reason.
Yeah,
you're supposed to be acted on. So
I also think a fun win today.
Yeah,
is wins we've been having more regularly.
Yeah,
is when we have those moments where we don't have like a meal at home planned.
Yeah,
and we're contemplating if we want to go out.
I know.
Or stay at home, and it's a win every time we decide to stay at home.
Mm.
It ends up always being a good decision.
Always.
And we have fun cooking together.
So much fun.
And although we would have fun out and about, there's like a hassle involved in that.
I know.
And like there's times for going out.
Totally.
And having food at a restaurant with friends or with each other, like date nights and stuff.
Totally.
But we got to a place where it was like we were doing it so often, it's comfortable.
I know.
And breaking the habit of like doing that.
But we can have just as much fun and connection time by cooking the meal because, one, okay, we're not on our phones because you're chopping. Like, you can't be on your phone. We can still talk. We're listening to music. Like, we can still make that experience fun and special just as much as going out, even though, you know, we love going out. We'll still do that.
No, but that's what I mean. It's a total win because of that experience of once you decide and make the decision to stay at home and cook,
mm-hmm,
that experience that comes along with that.
Totally.
Of cooking together. Recognizing that the food you're eating is actually probably
better for you,
better
and
quality,
and you make
tastes
it
tastes better a lot of times.
Totally,
you made it. You're like, I don't know,
feeding it's just your fun. Family, like it's like a fulfilling.
And it feels like we kind of cheated because we're using like a
home chef.
Yeah,
whatever. But it's still, a step. Yeah. It's a step. You know, it's just momentum, mm-hmm, in the kitchen. Okay, we have a workout at 8:30.
Yeah, we gotta get to bed.
My eyes are dragging.
Well, we love you guys. So, thanks for sitting through all of our bullshit the past like few weeks.
I know.
A few months, really.
Oh my god.
And sticking with us.
You're still hanging on. I promise, like, we've got fun adventures coming.
But at the same time, don't view it as bullshit. Like, we don't.
It's no,
like,
it's just...
it's important things that have to happen to get you to a better place.
Yeah.
In terms of, like, you have to take time for yourself.
Everyone has trials and tribulations, and we, like, are just... have to be more vocal about ours because we share our life here. So
yeah,
that's what I was kind of explaining the other day.
Last thing I'll say, I had an interesting thought.
Yeah.
Earlier today, and it's like when I just said thanks for sticking through all the bullshit. I think what I mean is like thank you for sticking through the less consistent posting schedule of the past 2 months.
Mm-hmm.
that you were used to receiving over the past like 3 or 4 years from us. But the importance of that is sometimes it's okay to sit patiently on something if it's being built. Like, would you rather us continue posting consistently over the past like 2 months to then like not have something great coming down the road, or give us the time and give yourself the time and patience of waiting so you can experience what's to come?
You lost me.
Lost you?
Yeah. But maybe they got it. You're showing the comparison to show.
I'm not showing a comparison. I'm saying thank you for sitting through the bullshit. The bullshit, aka being something that's good for us. Something that wasn't that fun for you to experience because y'all weren't getting what you were used to. But now something better is coming because you were patient. Correct. So we thank you for that. Is what I'm trying to say.
You will reap the rewards.
You will reap the rewards.
We owe you.
Yeah. But anyways, love you guys.
We're going to sleep. Good night.
Bye, y'all. Yeah.